But let's get back to stock market. And the stock that's really dragging the market right now is HDFC. Vaibhav Agarwal, VP Research at Angel Broking now joins us. Vaibhav, good morning. What do you think is bothering the street the most since yesterday's numbers have come out? And what's your own call on the stock?
Well, I think if you adjust HDFC Bank's operating income, for the dividend actually that they've earned, what's coming out is actually the operating level growth is a little bit on the lower side than expected. Partly it is because the loan growth itself, even on the individual and on the overall side at 12%, the reported on the books is lower because they did sell a lot of loans to HDFC Bank, in this quarter. So, somewhere the operating income growth is actually coming in a little bit lower than expected once you remove the effect of dividend and sale of investments.
Okay. What is your projection on loan growth for the remaining part of this fiscal, Vaibhav, in terms of individual as well as non-individual or their corporate book?
Well, as far as the non-individual is concerned, as far as we understand, the environment still remains a little weak, and the management's appetite for what is available currently in the market is not very high. I think they would continue to wait and watch, and if the environment does improve, keeping in mind their strong, credit quality standards, probably 3 or 4 quarters down the line, that growth can start reviving. But in this fiscal, it's likely to be on the lower side, in the single digit kind of levels where it is. On the individual home loan side, if you actually see the underlying growth, it's quite strong. Even if you look at the sector, it's one of the fastest growing segments within credit growth overall at the industry level as well. It's just the question of how much HDFC Bank actually chooses to retain. So earlier they were retaining 55%, now they are retaining 70% of the loans they sourced for HDFC, and that has brought down that growth rate. I think if they continue to retain 70%, which could be likely, then in that case, HDFC's own loan growth could be somewhere in the 12 to 14% mark itself where it is currently. If HDFC Bank reduces the amount that it's procuring, then maybe that growth rate can pick. But we would go with around a 12 to 14% kind of growth for HDFC in FY16.
Okay, in that case, Vaibhav, it's still not a cheap stock. Do you think it needs to derate a bit more to factor in the near-term concerns?
Right, actually, in the near term, the stock has also done reasonably well, and so it's trading at about 4.5 times. Ironically, if you look at HDFC Bank itself, it's trading at about 3.5 time levels. So and if you look at the earnings growth, it's the private banks like HDFC Bank which are giving higher earnings growth as well. So in that sense, yeah, we would prefer going with the bank rather than the NBFC right now. So for HDFC, we would have a neutral call right now considering the valuations and probably in the near term, the fact that the loan growth and earnings growth is going to be on the lower side.
Okay. What about the stake sale or the impending stake sale where with regards to HDFC Life, do you think that that would be a game changer, that incremental 9% that HDFC would be selling to Standard Life?
So we have to wait and watch what kind of valuation unlocking happens. But based on the previous transaction itself, we are valuing it at around close to the 20,000 crore plus kind of a level. And if there is a better valuation that they get for that, then yeah, that would lead to some bit of further upside. But ultimately that is gonna impact the stock in terms of maybe 10, 20 rupees. Ultimately the bigger value drivers are the holding in the bank itself as well as the core business. And the life business as such in terms of contribution to the stock price is not that high.
Okay, Vaibhav, since we have you with us, a word on Axis Bank as well that comes out with numbers today.
We are expecting about a decent 18-19% kind of earnings growth for Axis Bank. Their core growth has also been quite strong. Loan growth is about 20-23% levels, which we would expect to sustain. The key number again to watch out for would be on the slippage front. Their guidance for the year is that they would do less of stressed assets compared to what they did in FY15. By that metric, we would not expect more than 1,200-1,300 crore of slippage. And if the number does come higher than that, that could be a bit of a disappointment. So that would be a key number to watch out for. Other than that, I think on the operating front, they're doing quite well, both on loan growth, even fee income is decent. So as such, this stock looks quite good in terms of current valuations as well. We have a buy on the stock. And based on the fact that the earnings growth outlook is reasonably strong.
Okay, fair enough. And your top pick in the banking space, along with your rating on Axis?
So Axis itself, like I said, we have a buy rating with an upside of about 25%, and it is one of our top picks as well within the sector. Apart from Axis Bank, we also like the other private sector banks like HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank as well. So those are also, you know, amongst our top picks.
Okay. Fair enough, Vaibhav. We leave it on that note. Thanks very much for joining in and talking to us about HDFC Limited as well as Axis Bank, which comes out with its numbers today. And that stock, in fact, has moved into the green ahead of its numbers, up around 0.5%. Time for a break now. But up next, the MD of Blue Star.